The White House says it is confident that Republican senators stand solidly behind the president on impeachment. One America's Emerald Robinson spoke to Stephanie Grisham for this exclusive interview.
For House Democrats, they passed that impeachment inquiry resolution on Thursday. It's up to the Senate now. I mean, of course, the impeachment's going to go on in the House, but ultimately, what happens, it depends on the Senate.
Correct.
Some senators have defected, Republican senators, from the president's positions. For example, you had several of those, a dozen or so, that went against the president's executive order on the southern border crisis. So in saying that, how focused is this administration on the possibility that there could be 67 senators who would vote to impeach?
We're not worried about that, to be honest with you. I think that when it comes to politics, of course, there's going to be Republicans who disagree potentially with the president on some issues. You're talking about Syria. That has nothing to do with the impeachment part of it. The Republicans have been very strong in knowing that this impeachment inquiry has been nothing but a kangaroo court. There's nothing to it. We had phase one, which was doing secret hearings behind closed doors. And now yesterday's vote, they're saying that there's going to be public hearings, but then there's a loophole in there that Schiff can decide if and when we can question anybody. So really, yesterday's vote was nothing. We don't get to actually have our side until we get to the third phase, which is the Judiciary Committee, which in the United States, you're innocent until proven guilty. The way the Dems have set this up, we're guilty and have to prove our innocence. Luckily, we put out a transcript a few weeks ago, and anybody can read it, and they can see that nothing was done wrong, and that there was no quid pro quo.
So in saying that, couldn't the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell just shut this down by holding a vote in a day, getting senators on the record, and saying, look, this is going nowhere, so there's no point in doing a full impeachment inquiry?
I think right now it's in the House still, so that's where the focus is. We'll see what happens in the Senate. But at the end of the day, we as a White House, we're not worried, and I think the president has demonstrated in the last 2 weeks since Congress has been back, he's been working. They have been screaming and yelling impeachment. They left again yesterday. They now have another 12 days off. Makes me want to be a congressman, frankly. But the president continues to work, and that's what we're focused on.
The vacation time is good.
Yes.
There is word from the Hill that the majority leader is looking at 4 to 6 weeks in the schedule potentially for an impeachment inquiry. Wouldn't that validate it if he gives it 4 to 6 weeks? What do you think about that?
I don't know yet. I think it's a little bit premature to say. I mean, I think there's a lot of speculation and a lot of what's going on. We'll see how these next couple of phases play out in the House, and then we'll move to the Senate portion and focus on that.
So we know that the administration legislatively is still looking to push through the USMCA, but with all this going on in the House and on impeachment, how can this administration continue to push the president's policies and agenda? What are you doing?
So we continue to hold meetings. USMCA, we are still optimistic that it will go through. Nancy Pelosi, unfortunately, is slow rolling this, and it's all for politics. I think that's something that could be done, but we have to work with them to do it. We did have great jobs numbers announced, 182,000 jobs announced in October. Since the president took office, we've got, you know, over 6 million jobs that have been added. So he continues to work. We've got criminal justice reform. We've got story after story there. He continues to work. Trade deals are in the works for China, we're hoping. And that's all we can do. We're doing the best we can on our end. The Dems, once they decide to come back to work, hopefully they'll come and work with us.
Sources are telling One American News that the president and his son-in-law, Jared Kushner, are building a war room, an impeachment war room within the White House to handle this. Is that the case?
So actually, the president has been very clear on this. He's done nothing wrong, and he doesn't feel that there needs to be a war room. A lot of people compare the Clinton days, the Nixon days, and that they had war rooms. The difference there is that our president, Trump, has done nothing wrong. So as of right now, we don't have any war room. We've got great teams in place. The president just said he's very happy with his team. If we need to add a couple of people, we might, but that would be just to focus on impeachment, just like we've got people who focus on immigration or focus on health care.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.